Okay, here I am on Headingley Lane. Just coming into Headingley, we can see St Michael's church spire with a steeplejack scaffold on top of it there. And this is the road that is claimed to be so bad that we have to have a trolleybus system running nearby. Well, I'm just going to go and meet somebody now who would be very much affected by this proposed trolleybus scheme, which would run up there through the woodland. Here we have the old gatehouse for Headingley Castle, which is now the caretaker's lodge for St Columba's United Reformed Church. There we go. So here we are, and I'm just going to meet the good folks who live here.
Ah! Hello.
Hello.
Oh,
no.
Hello.
Hello
there.
Hello.
Well, I'm very grateful that you were interested to meet me and talk about your situation. As you know, my name's Claire, and I wonder if you'd just like to introduce yourself for the cameras.
I'm David Stevenson.
I'm Brenda Stevenson.
Well, thank you very much, David and Brenda. Well, obviously I've come here this afternoon to talk to you about the proposed trolleybus scheme, which the council and Metro want to put up through this beautiful piece of woodland above you here. But first, I wonder if you could just tell me how long you've lived here in this beautiful Victorian gatehouse.
7 years, haven't we? Shall we move up here? It's a bit quieter.
By all means, yes. And here we are, just a few yards up, and suddenly it does get a lot quieter, doesn't it?
Oh, it's beautiful.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Yes.
There we go, it's a bit quieter here.
There we go. Well, of course, all the greenery helps to dampen the traffic noise a bit, doesn't it?
And the beautiful wildlife.
Yes.
Yes.
Birds singing.
Yes. We can hear.
Yeah.
Yes.
You're in a different place altogether.
Yeah, and yep. It's barely 10 yards, is
it?
That's it. Yes.
That's it.
And when did you come to live here?
Six years gone February.
That's it. Yeah. Yes. Yes.
17th yeah. of February.
And how did you feel about coming to live here in this frankly beautiful
location?
As you can see, we've got the road here. Mm. Just come up here and you're in a different world.
And here we are, you said this is the...
It's just not heading, it's not, you just don't connect, you think you're out in the country.
Yes.
It's beautiful, you can go around, it just keeps swirling round. Look at the trees.
This is like a country meadow, isn't it?
It is.
Yes.
The birds, various birds.
But standing here, I'll be standing in the middle of the tracks, basically.
Yes.
So
this, look at this, what we can see.
Yes.
Beautiful.
Yeah, fantastic trees, aren't they? They're beautiful
and
mature trees. And so when did you first hear about this proposed trolleybus scheme which wants to put a road or something through here?
It's been ongoing for quite some years,
Yeah, yes.
And
it's just picked up momentum recently.
Yes.
Well, I
yes.
think at one stage it was more or less a no-no.
Yes.
Yes, there was sudden impetus and...
That's right, yes. So that would probably have been when the original tram was nearly put through, but then that was cancelled about 3 or 4 years ago. And then recently this new trolleybus scheme, which is slightly different, has been brought back to us. So what do you feel about the... what do you feel about the situation with the traffic in front of your house?
Well, it's always been the same, hasn't it?
Well, you sort of...
It's just one of the things living there, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah.
But we don't really mind that, because we can
walk out here.
Yes,
you're in a different world.
Isn't this fantastic? Yes,
look. We're sat in his garden. Yeah. We can't hear a thing at the top of the garden, but...
That's it.
Got this behind
I mean,
us.
Yeah, and you've every form of wildlife you can imagine. Pipistrelle bats. We have a fine few owls, haven't we? We've owls.
We had deer as well.
Foxes. Woodpeckers.
The
wildlife
of different
is just
birds, what we see is unbelievable, the colours of them.
Yeah. And how do you think that the environment, the wildlife and so on, will be affected by...
Oh, it'll disappear.
It'll disappear. It'll be nil.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It'll disappear. It'll...
It's a safe haven for them.
Yeah, that's it. And you can't bring it back by just planting a few saplings. It's just impossible.
These trees has been here for... Yeah. I wouldn't like to guess. Yeah. But saplings, you can't replace saplings with this. Birds wouldn't be here. There's no coverage anymore. It'd be gone.
So, what do you think about the proposed benefit to...
None whatsoever. No. So, the traffic will be just the same, no matter what. That won't alter in the least.
And how would you feel about having your beautiful gatehouse cottage sandwiched between a busy road and passing trolleybus?
No.
And do you know any other people in Headingley who feel the same?
Quite a lot.
A lot of people. Yes. Everybody I've spoke to are against it.
I've yet to speak to anyone what's for it. And I don't think they exist, quite honestly.
Well, of course, there are a few councillors who are trying to persuade us about this.
Because they don't have to be here with us.
No.
We are the people.
We lose it. This is what we're losing.
Yeah.
And this is what matters to
them.
They have
nothing to lose.
No. Yeah.
They're not here. They're not living here. They don't see what's going on.
No.
Yeah.
They're sat in the office and just...
Yeah.
We'll do this, and we'll do that. Coming up with these brilliant ideas, what they think.
Yeah.
But it's not a brilliant idea whatsoever.
This is it. No. And time has come now to do something about it. And we've got to take it as far as...
The council think we're just going to sit back, but some people have a lot of fight in them, and we have got fight. We'll fight. It's a bitter end.
This is it, yeah.
So what do you think about councillors who... I know some personally who I've spoken to, and they have personal reservations, but they're saying, well, we have to vote with the party whip, even though we're not sure this is the right thing to do in terms of loss of environment and heritage and stuff. What would you say to those councillors who are sitting on the fence, basically?
Well, it's just ridiculous, isn't it?
They should be voting as they think. Individuals this subject, because the people here in Headingley have voted them in to speak for us as individuals, not as groups. We vote for one councillor in the area, and that councillor should be putting our views forward. They shouldn't be doing it as a group.
So how do you feel about the fact that they're trying to persuade you of what they want or what their party wants, and which possibly they don't even believe themselves?
It's all wrong, isn't it?
Well, they're not considering the people of Headingley's vote for the next time they come round for one. That's all I say.
Yes. Yeah. So,
they're failing us. They're failing our votes, what we've given to come into this area.
Yeah.
And it will be on the next voting. They'll realise we should have listened. But then it'd be too late.
Well, what would you think about the... outcome for Headingley and local residents should this scheme
be
put forward?
It'll be a disaster.
Headingley will lost its character. Everything.
They're just upsetting people's lives with it.
And
we've
for
voted
nothing,
them,
basically.
We've voted them in to do this. With the goodness of our heart, we've put them in. And they're just upsetting us lives. We haven't got one if this goes ahead.
No, we're not.
We're not stopping.
No.
Yeah.
No. How can you live on a highland?
Yeah.
The road at one side and a trolleybus rattling.
Yes. Yes, indeed. Well, I wonder if, just before we wind up and finish, I wonder if perhaps you could just show me a little bit further up your beautiful garden where the proposed route would go.
We're better off this way, aren't we? We're better off this way.
Oh, yeah?
Looking downwards.
Okay, righto. Well, I just love these huge trees up here. Yeah, and then there's this lovely meadow which I covered in my earlier video with a rather less good camera.
Wildflower
meadow.
Untouched.
And So the proposed route would go across, slap bang through the middle of this lovely wildflower meadow. There's trees over there that it would have to cut through.
Look at the peaceful.
Isn't it peaceful here? And we're only 10, 15, 20 yards from the main road.
And you can't hear nothing.
And as you stand, well, this...
I think this is the view what you wanted to show me, isn't it?
Yeah, this is it.
Right.
That's okay. The route. That's the route.
Stand back and get this
view.
Righto, well this is the bit of woodland. Let me just...
What's not going to exist?
Yeah, well, it's not a done deal yet, is it?
No,
so we have to...
But that's the...
That's what they want to cut down, basically, isn't
that's
it?
That's it, yep.
And... Yep. It's not just a row of trees, is it? Because it's a full...
No, it's full wood. It's full wood.
It's full wood.
Right
back.
Yes.
Yeah, it's full wood.
Yeah, and I don't know if you know if you could reel off a few of the species of trees, which you know in there?
Yeah, we've got sycamore, we've got horse chestnut, and...
I think I've seen an oak in there.
Yeah, there's oak, beech. There's some good beech trees in
there.
Yes. There's a good... variety of good mature trees.
And how long do you think it takes for trees to get to this kind
of... Some of these you'll be looking on going best part of 200 years.
Yeah, right. So,
and they're all healthy, good, healthy, strong trees.
Well, it looks...
If you turn round, this tree here...
We planted this after 12 months.
Okay.
So this tree here has been there nearly 6 years to get to that size.
Right, yeah. So...
The 6 years
growth. It's a lovely little tree, but obviously it's got a long way to go.
Yeah.
So how long do you think it take for something like this, which is a, as you say, I think it's a Rowan Mountain Ash, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Which is about 7 years old or so.
Yeah.
And...
to get to, it's a long way to go, hasn't it?
Yes.
A long
way
to go.
So we're talking over a century.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
Whatever trees they might
And you'll find in the bottom of it all, there's rhododendrons.
Yeah. So it's a complex ecosystem.
Yeah, that's it, yeah. Mm. Yeah. And it's just so diverse in wildlife.
Mm. Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, righto. Well, I think I'll just... wind up now.
That's
if I can just say thank you very much.
Oh, you're welcome.
And I hope that people will enjoy this video
and we'll be
think about
100%.
It. Fantastic.
Yeah.
Well, thank you very much indeed.
Yeah. Thank you.